Well, good morning, church family. It is Thursday, April the 23rd, and I hope you're doing well today. I'm praying for you today. We love you, we miss you, and I just want to let you know that our church staff is thinking about you constantly and preparing and making plans for hopefully meeting all together soon whenever everything is lifted. And so just to let you know that that is what's happening. Today's devotion actually comes from chapter 43 of Isaiah 1 through 5. Again, it's our last day in that verse. But I want to read it to you and then just tell you the who God is today coming out of this verse. It's great, great verses. So chapter 43 of Isaiah, verses 1 through 5 again, says this. But now, thus says the Lord, He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by my name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Cush and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my eyes and honored, and I love you. I give men in return for you, peoples in exchange for your life. Fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east and from the west. I will gather you. In these five verses, there's two fear nots. First one we talked about a couple days ago, fear not, for I have redeemed you. And then later in the verse, in chapter 5, in verse 5, it says, fear not, for I am with you. Now, I want us to understand, first, God redeems us in this passage. It first says, fear not, for I have redeemed you. And then later on, it says, fear not, for I am with you. And I just want to tell you that through this, God is with you. Now, there's a couple verses in here that I want to read over again. I want you to hear it. It says, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. And the truth of the matter is today, and just like every day, but today in this season of life, I want us to understand that God is our sustainer. He sustains you. He sustains me. No matter what we're going through, He sustains us. And it says the fires will not consume you and the waters will not overwhelm you. And my prayer is that today you will not be overwhelmed and you will not be consumed by what is going on, but you will be able to press on because God sustains us through these times. And not only does God walk with us through these times, and it's amazing to me that it doesn't say that He'll take the circumstances away. He says He will walk with us through these times. He will sustain us through these times. And kind of to go along with Pastor Zach's message from last Sunday, not only will He sustain you through these times, He also gives you a reason through this time. And that reason is to tell people about Jesus. That reason is to do the Great Commission. That reason is to shine bright where you are. I believe God has placed us in this season to be with our families, to be next to people that we love so much. And through that time, and in that time, my prayer is that you will be a light to your family, that you will teach your kids about Jesus, that you will teach your spouse, encourage your spouse or whomever you're with about Jesus during this time, because God is our sustainer and He will be with us through it, and we will not be overwhelmed or be consumed by it. But also that we realize that through those times, through this time, God has given us a purpose, and that purpose is to point people to Jesus, is to lift up the name of Christ. And so that is my prayer for you today. That's my prayer for me today, that we remember why we're here. And that is to share the love of Jesus with people, to point people to Jesus, to tell people the gospel. And so don't forget, He is our sustainer. He will be with us through this time. And He gives us a purpose through this time as well. God bless you guys. I hope and pray that you're doing well. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I just want to thank you. God, I thank you for the love and the grace that you've given us. God, I thank you for the mercy and grace that just comes through Christ. And Lord, my prayer is that today, maybe we are beginning to feel overwhelmed or consumed, but we rely and we believe and that you will sustain us, that you will give us the strength to walk through whatever we're going through. And God, that whenever we realize that and we rely on your strength and your abilities to sustain us, that we realize that we have a purpose. And that purpose is to point people to Jesus. That purpose is to point people to your Son. God, that purpose is to share the love of Christ. And so my prayer is that you give us that strength today to do that. Lord, thank you for sustaining us during this time. We love you, we praise you, we worship you, and in Christ's holy name I pray. Amen. So church family, I'm praying that today you will rely on the sustaining strength of Christ, that you will rely and believe that in the God who sent his Son Jesus, that you will believe that he is your strength, that he will sustain you, and that you just resonate in that, that you would just sit and realize that he is bringing you through this. Don't be overwhelmed. I know it's easy for me to say, but don't be overwhelmed because God is our strength. Don't be consumed because God will sustain you. God will sustain us during this time. God bless you guys. My prayer is that you're in the truth of God's word, that you turn up the volume of the truth of God's word, and that always, always there is hope in Jesus. God bless. Have a great day.